A grateful welcome from Hindustan Institute of Technology, Coimbatore. I am Mrs. B. Gomati, Assistant Professor, Department of Science and Humanities. Today we are going to see about properties of matter from engineering physics for semester 1. Matter is anything that has mass and takes up space by having volume. We called matter. It can be in the form of solids, liquids or gases. When you look at an object, you are able to see many of its properties. In this session, we are going to see one of the important property, that is elasticity. Elasticity is a branch of physics which deals with the elastic property of materials. When an external force is applied to your body, there will be some change in its length, shape and volume. When the external force is removed, the body regains its original shape and size, then the body is said to be a perfectly elastic body. If the body does not regain its original shape and size after the removal of applied force, then it is said to be a perfectly plastic body. This phenomenon is known as plasticity. See example, rubber bands and other stretchy materials display elasticity. Modeling clay is relatively inelastic and retains a new shape even after the force that caused it to change is no longer being exerted. Stress is defined as the restoring force per unit area which brings back the body to its original state from the deformed state. For example, you take a tennis ball and press it with your thumb. You can see ball undergoing temporary deformation. But you cannot do it easily because there is some internal resistance offered against force applied by your thumb. That resistance offered is nothing but stress. So the deformation it has undergone is strain. In simple words, stress is the internal resistance offered by the body against externally applied load. So, under strain is a change in the dimension of the body per unit original dimension. So, strain is defined as the change in dimension produced by the external force on the body. On the other way, it can be also defined as the ratio of the change in dimension to the original dimension. There is no unit for strain. Hooke's law, it is found that stress and strain always accompany each other. Without stress, strain will not be there. So, Robert Hooke proposed a relationship between stress and strain. According to this law, stress is directly proportional to strain produced within the elastic limit. So, stress directly proportional to strain means the formula E is equal to stress by strain. The unit is Newton per meter squared. So, E refers the modulus of elasticity. The E mainly depends on the nature of material. Hooke's law is important because it helps us understand how a stretchy object will behave. And when it is stretched or compacted. Hooke's law can be applied in many things in everyday life. Most commonly Hooke's law is applied in springs because of their elasticity. So the force of a person jumping on the trampoline, these are the translate into the springs. So causing them to stretch a certain distance. So these are the importance of Hooke's law in day-to-day life. A classification of elastic modulus. There are three types of modulus are there. The first one is a Young's modulus, second one is a bulk modulus, and third one is a rigidity modulus. Let us see one by one. Young's modulus. It is defined as the ratio between the longitudinal stress to longitudinal strain within the elastic limits. Let us consider a wire of length L within an area of cross section A. Let one end of the wire is fixed and other end is loaded. Let del L is the change in length due to the action of force. Then the longitudinal stress is equal to F by A. The longitudinal strain is equal to del L by L. So Young's modulus Y is equal to F by A divided by del L by L. The unit is Newton per meter squared or Pascals. So next one is a bulk modulus. It is defined as the ratio between the volume stress or bulk stress to the volume strain or bulk strain within the elastic limits. So, bulk modulus can be written as bulk stress by bulk strain. The unit is Newton per meter squared. For example, let us consider a body of volume V within the area of cross section A. So, let three equal forces, otherwise all the in all direction. Okay, the forces are acting in all direction. Let del V is the change in volume due to the action of forces. So the volume stress can be written as F by A. The volume strain can be written as del V by V. So the bulk modulus is equal to F by A divided by del V by V. So the unit is Newton per meter squared. Next one is a rigidity modulus. It is defined as the ratio between the tangential stress to shearing strain within the elastic limits. So let us consider a solid cube whose lower face is fixed. Okay, so the tangential force F is applied over the upper face. So the result is that the cube gets deformed to rhombus shape. So the already cube is in, it's a cubic shape. So it is changed as a rhombus shape with a make an angle theta. So we can write the tangential stress is equal to F by A. So the rigidity modulus N is equal to tangential stress by shearing strain. So N is equal to F by A theta. The unit is Newton per meter squared. So the rigidity modulus means it is change in their angle. That is called rigidity modulus. Inelasticity plays an important role in everyday life. The elastic behavior is one such property which especially decides the structural design of the columns and beams of the building. As far as the structural engineer is concerned, the amount of stress that the design could withstand is a primary safety factor. A bridge has to be designed in such a way that it should have the capacity to withstand the load of the flowing traffic, the force of winds, and even its own weight. The elastic behavior, or in other words, the bending of beams, is a major concern over the stability of the buildings or bridges. For example, to reduce the bending of the beam for a given load, one should use the material within a higher Young's modulus of elasticity.